Good evening, good evening. This is Mary once again. I want to talk a little bit about this, the abortion bill and what's going on. And you know, I'm older. I'm 65, and I've seen a lot of changes in my lifetime. And the thing about a woman's body, you know, every woman doesn't want to be a mother. And then the pro-life people, they may say, well, if she doesn't want to be a mother, then she should, you know, do the measures to prevent this. There's, you know, mistakes and things do happen. And it's kind of, I guess you could say, decent of the bill, Donald Trump. And, you know, they have these clauses that if it's rape, incest, detrimental to the mother's health, you could, I think if the baby is going to be, you know, mentally retarded or something like that, then abortion is permitted. And I could agree with that. But a woman who just doesn't want to have that baby, I think it's up to her to be more responsible. But the thing about it is, I don't understand how people, how our country can say the right to life, and then you turn around and have the death penalty. What gives you the right to kill anybody? I mean, these are people who are living and breathing. They might have done something wrong, which they, well, we don't know, because it's a lot of people have been killed, murdered, and were innocent. So we just don't know. But how can you be the judge of that? But you want to preserve the life of an unborn child, but you have the right to kill somebody that's been here for a while. That's what confuses me. And look like the more I stay here and the more I think I know, the dumber I get, you know? It's like, that doesn't make sense. Why do you do that? And then you say that church and state is separate, but then you still hold on a little bit, our country, to this good book called the Bible. But you take God out of the school and the Christmas holidays and stuff like that. But yet you still hold on what parts, I don't know, just throw the Bible away completely then. If we can't have prayer in the schools, which I'm not for prayer in the schools, I'm, the Bible is just a fairy tale book to me, so, but I don't understand how people can hold on parts of that. That's a whole different sort of subject, because I made videos about how I feel about the Bible. But that's something that majority of people in this country and Christians, it takes, I mean, a washing, a many, many washings to get that out of your mind. Because I'm doing a whole lot better because I don't say the Lord said and the Bible said. That part is gone. So I'm still working on me. But like I say, I still pray and I still say, thank you, God, or thank you, Jesus. And That's not going to ever come out of me. I mean, as old as I am, that's embedded in me. Even though it may not be true, she in there lapping up water, poor baby. This medicine must make her really thirsty. But I don't understand that. So, say for instance, back to the abortion thing. Mentally ill people have these babies, and I guess they have the right to get pregnant, have babies too, but supposing they have mentally ill children, you got to figure out what to do with them. I don't know. That abortion bill is kind of so many different aspects of it. Now, I don't think that a woman should just selectively decide, I don't want this baby because I'm pregnant by this man. I don't like him. I know a young lady, she's probably 45 now. Yeah, she's the same age as my oldest son. But if she got pregnant by a man that she was just kicking it with, and he might have been too dark or too ugly, she would go and have an abortion. And then 3 months later, she's pregnant again by a light-skinned dude. I want to have this baby. And you let this baby live, but you kill another baby. That kind of stuff doesn't make sense to me. I just don't understand that. And I couldn't do it, because the baby that this girl wanted to have, a pretty little boy, I mean, a light-skinned, I'm not color struck, because I married a very dark-skinned man, but I don't see color like that. But this baby that she had by the pretty man, as she called, this baby got sick. She almost lost him. And she was scared to death. And she said, "Ooh," she called me Aunt Mary. "Aunt Mary, God might be talking to me about the babies I killed." I said, "Honey, I don't know. That's you and your God. I don't know. But you figure it out." And I didn't give her no advice about it at all. But I don't know. And you know, you think about the females in mammals and things, you know, dog, cat, pandas, bears, gorillas, monkeys, whatever. The female, she may reject that child, not nurse it. And I had a dog. The dog name was Greedy, a female. And Greedy was crazy. I don't know. And she came to me. I didn't get Greedy. She's just old street dog. And she just started coming around and we started feeding her. But she ended up getting pregnant by this great big bully Rottweiler that was running the streets. And that's a loose one, a wild one. He just has to be like that. But she got pregnant by this Rottweiler and she had about 8 babies, but I couldn't even go out there to see about it because she was vicious. Ooh, she growled at us, and she had dug a real, like a mud pit to have these dogs in, the puppies in. And then my neighbor, oh, nosy neighbor, she came over and said she was going to call the police because that dog had been eating up these little puppies. These puppies couldn't even walk, and she would just, I didn't even know it because the dog wouldn't let me out there, so I wasn't going to get bit by this dog. But she really was killing these dogs. But I said that to say, why don't they have a study? I mean, they might have a study, we just don't know, as to why some females in the mammal species, why do they reject their offspring? Because it happens. And it was one woman, I saw it on the internet a couple of years ago, she had a baby in the hospital, and they would come give it, you know, they give you the baby, and the nurse found her biting her baby, and they were able to save the baby, but she was actually, I don't know if she was going to eat the baby, but she was biting it. And they took the baby away from her. And maybe some mental illness or something, I don't know. But every female is not equipped to be a mother. But I don't know. I just hope I don't reincarnate again and come back and maybe be a female and have to want an abortion and can't have it. But even in the case of an abortion, you only have 9 months to be pregnant, and you have to go through the labor pains and have the baby. So 9 months is not long, and even if you don't want it, after you have it, drop it off at the fire station or whatever, or leave the hospital, don't even bring it home. Do the adoption, the orphanage thing, you know, before you give birth. You don't have to abort a child. Just go through the pregnancy and the labor. Just do it. And it may help you to get your tubes tied. I don't even know if they'll tie your tubes, though. I don't know that. They probably got stipulations on that. But having a baby is just, it's not that bad. I mean, the pains are bad, the labor pains, and I ended up having a C-section with mine. I'm sure glad that the C-sections were around, because I would have died. It just wasn't going to be no baby. Because every woman can't deliver a child. So, I don't know. But that's just my little take on this abortion thing. But I know in the case of rape and incest and all that, women should not have to be forced to have that baby or have it and keep it. They can't make you keep the baby. But I can understand both sides, but I don't think men need to be dipping their finger in the till, because they don't have no vagina. They can't bring forth a life. That ain't none of your business. So when I see a old white man or a white man or even a man, period, voicing his opinion about it, no, this don't have nothing to do with you about having a baby. Let them have one monthly cycle and they'll just jump off the first bridge. So leave women alone. We come from a whole different species. Ugh, that makes me sick when I see a man preaching and talking about abortions. You have a baby. That's what you do. But how many minutes I got? 12. Another thing I was talking about, I want to talk about. You see, I'm looking at the little notes because I forget what's on my mind. But this thing with this baby, Malia, you know, it's so sad. So sad what happened to her. This boy, the mother, how can you know this man had been molesting your child, and you go off to your father's, be with him in his dying hour? I can understand that, but you couldn't let your mother keep your child. You don't do that. I blame the mother in that situation. But I don't understand women who are so hard up to have a man to be with them in their house, to say they're with them. I don't understand that. Because me and my ex separated, we stayed separated for a long time before we got a divorce, because I think 10 years, after 10 years of marriage, we stayed married 27 years, but after 10 years, hell, I left him. I had male friends, but they never spent the night at my house. You know, I just wasn't going to have you in my space and around my children. It just wasn't going to happen. I didn't like you like that. But I don't understand these women bringing these strange men into their cave and around their children, and you have and you know, it used to be girls, but they're raping little boys now. It's sad though. I had my ex's, his nephew, and the poor baby, he had been this guy was molesting him day in and day out for years, and nobody knew this. And the boy's uncle told the boy, he said, "You stink. You smell like you've been fucking. What you doing?" And the boy just broke down and cried. And he told him what was going on. He said he hurt so bad. His rectum was hurting so bad, but the boy had all sorts of diseases. He wasn't but 11 years old. And this man had been doing him like this since he was 8 years old. And this little boy's uncle went to find this man because they knew the man, but he had threatened the little boy and told him if he told, he would kill everybody in his family. And this baby boy believed that. And his uncle got guns and he got his gangsters and they were finna kill this boy. And I mean, this man, was so afraid he turned himself in. But I think he got, I think it's 15 years for doing this. And the baby boy, he's grown now and he's doing well. I mean, he grew up to be like 6'3". But can you imagine how he's scarred up? So you can't say that, my son and I could have my boyfriend over him and he could live with me and he could babysit my son. It doesn't matter. Girl or daughter, son or daughter, they are not safe. I don't understand this. I mean, they raping the boys and the girls as well. So, I don't know. But women, take care of the children that you have. And even if you don't have a man that is living in the house with you, that's okay. And if he just say he love you and he got to have you, and you know, put your stipulations and your rules and have some rules. That's what you have to do. You have your rules and things you are not going to do. Your standards. And base it on your children. God, it's so sad. I hate women are so insecure that they have to just go get anybody. But anyway, I'm going to get off of here. Come here, Sonny. If some people want to see you, come here. I said I was going to make Sonny a channel. Come here. She's looking at me like I'm crazy. If I had some food, she would come here. But she's doing so much better, poor baby. We still got to do some more tests. I'm going to try to work it out in phases because veterinary bills are so high. God is high. But I'm so glad she's feeling better. She's playing and just happy. Poor baby, she probably was hurting when she went to the bathroom. But I'm so glad she goes to the pee pad and when she pee, I can tell what's going on. But people who take their dogs out, how would they know if they were bleeding? You know, and they're urine. But she's so much better. She's playing and jumping and stuff. But anyway, I'm going to say good night. I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.